I can use one of the four fundamental forces of nature to defy the other right here, right now. Boom! Take that, gravity, electromagnetism, forever! Howdy, boson buddies. This is DNews. I'm Trace. There are four fundamental forces in the universe. You know them. You love them. You're feeling some of them right now. Those are gravity, electromagnetism, weak nuclear, and strong nuclear. Each of these forces, mostly, fits into the standard model of physics, the rule book by which physicists explain our universe. Gravity is a bit weird, admittedly. By the way, if you don't know what those fundamental forces are about, you should watch this video. Recently, a new discovery out of the Hungarian Academy of Sciences got the media abuzz about a possible fifth fundamental force. But according to their paper in Physical Review Letters, they didn't really discover a new force. Nope. What they found was, drumroll, an anomaly. The team was looking for dark photons, which sounds like an awesome Norwegian death metal band, but in reality, it was a theorized subatomic particle related to dark matter. Dark matter is scientists' name for any matter that doesn't interact with the normal stuff the universe seems to be made of. You, me, the rock, the tree, the sun, and so on. The researchers said that their data anomaly might be a protophobic X boson that's 30 times more massive than an electron. Later, in a review, scientists at the University of California, Irvine said that this might indicate there is a fifth fundamental force of nature that no one has ever detected before. But first, let me explain. Bosons are a group of subatomic particles, theorized by Einstein and Satyendranath Bose. Boson is for Bose. The science is a bit complex, but essentially, bosons are particles which can exist in multiple states and have a spin with an integer or zero. Don't worry about it. But a good example would be the photon, the particles that make up light, which can also be waves. That's the multiple states. Look, it's not super important to fully understand this. Just picture a tiny part of an atom. Each of these bosons interacts in some way, which is how we can detect their presence. For example, the photon interacts with electrons, which are negatively charged, and protons, which are positively charged, right? That is all part of the electromagnetic power of the photon. Physicists believe each fundamental force of nature has a corresponding subatomic particle. As I mentioned, the photon carries electromagnetic force. Strong nuclear force is carried by the gluon. Weak nuclear force is carried by W and Z bosons. And theoretically, gravity would be carried by the graviton, though admittedly, scientists haven't actually found that one yet. So, if this new boson discovery is confirmed, and it hasn't been yet, it would show a force that interacts with electrons, which again are negatively charged, and neutrons, which have no charge at all. This is super strange. The lead researcher from the UC Irvine team speculates that this could be the indication of a, quote, grander, more fundamental force. But it could also be the key to finally detecting dark matter, which, again, is matter in the universe we haven't been able to detect yet because it doesn't seem to interact with anything. This protophobic X boson interacts very lightly and in unexpected ways that could prompt physicists to start looking for interactions that they would have easily missed otherwise. A new force could add more chapters to the standard model of physics. Of course, we don't actually know yet. Other scientists at the European Organization for Nuclear Research are looking to confirm these findings, and some scientists are skeptical of the findings altogether, so more research is definitely needed. Practically speaking, we have no idea what confirmation of this boson could prove. In 600 BC, the Greeks discovered if you rub animal fur on a bit of amber, you get a strange attraction, and now we know that's static electricity. But it would be centuries before we learn to master electromagnetism. These new chapters of science have to start somewhere, and maybe, just maybe, this was it. Do you want to know how they smash atoms together to find new particles? I went to the Large Hadron Collider and got a tour. It was so cool. Here's how it works.
They collide about 25 nanoseconds. So you have a bunch colliding with another bunch. You may have a proton here and a proton here, which has a hard, what we call scattering, a hard event. And out of that comes out a whole mess of particles.
What do you guys think of this discovery? Does it matter in your day-to-day life? Maybe not. But let us know down in the comments and make sure you subscribe so that you get more DNews.